guys, it's Jess from Pizza Books, and today I'm here with a book review. And actually, I have been not doing a lot of book reviews lately because they are my least viewed videos, and I don't know if people really care. But I recently posted a book review for Reaper's Property by Joanna Wild, and it has almost 1,000 views now. So I guess you guys do enjoy some book reviews, and I've decided to do some reviews for some hyped books. And I want to share if it's worth the hype. And if you saw my vlog, you already know my feelings, but if you did not catch that, it's linked down below. I shared my whole vlog of reading this book, and that is The Cruel Prince by Holly Black. Now, this is a library copy. I'm trying to be better of not buying books and doing library copies first so that if I like it, I will buy the physical copy, and if I don't like it, I don't have to waste my money and I don't have to get rid of it. I just return it to the library. So this one is about the Fae, and so my only comparison to this one is A Court of Thorns and Roses. I don't read Fae. I don't really read a ton of fantasy, although I do really love a good fantasy if it has a good romance. And so I had no idea what this was about going in. I literally had no idea what it was about. I just knew it was about a cruel prince, and people were saying they did not like how cruel the prince was. So, I will let you guys know, this is about Jude, who is a human who is forced to live in the fairy world with her twin sister Taryn and her older sister Vivian, who is actually half fae. That's all I want to tell you. And so, this book ended up being a very good book for a non-fantasy reader. I buddy read this with Kayla from Literature Reads, I'll link her channel down below, and we were talking as we were reading, and it was super easy to get into. It was really easy to understand the world because Jude is an outsider. We do get Jude after she's been living there for I think about 10 years, so she's had a while to adjust, but Holly Black does a really good job of explaining what people look like, what their abilities are, what their hierarchy is like, what their monarchy is like, and so I felt like it was really easy going into this world and understanding the whole fantasy realm, because fantasy, adult fantasy intimidates me. This is definitely young adult fantasy, so going into fantasy, I'm always very hesitant because I don't like politics that much, and so like when things get very political and like very magical and like there's all these different things to know, I get kind of lost. That was not like it with this. This does get political, but it was very easy to follow. Going into this one, I think that it was right off the bat hitting you with a lot of action, and I was sucked into this story. I was really interested in Jude. I will say Jude's a twin with Taryn, and I'm a twin myself, and a lot of twin books I've been reading lately are twins where the main character is like the nice twin, and then the other twin is like really selfish and annoying, but not like overly annoying, but just like doesn't put the other twin first, and like the main character twin is the one who has to constantly make sacrifices for that twin. And so in this one, Jude and Taryn get along in the beginning, but then they're not completely loyal to one another. Jude is more loyal than Taryn, and that really annoyed me because as a twin myself, my sister and I would give the world for each other. We are super close. We're not like one of us is always getting in trouble and like putting the blame on the other one. No, we are equal in our relationship, and so I would love to see a book about twins like that. But other than that, I'm just being picky because like that's something that annoys me. I really love Jude's relationship with her entire family. I loved her relationship with her stepfather, kind of adoptive father, I don't know what to call him. I love her relationship with her little brother Oak, with her older sister Vivian, and trying to understand where Vivian's coming from because she is actually half fae in a world where the fae hate humans. And so I don't think I mentioned that, but Jude is definitely an outsider. The fae hate humans, but she is growing up and going to school with them and learning with them, and that's why they're cruel to her. So we have Cardin, who is the cruel prince. He has like this posse of people, which I love the aspect about him, how he had like a group of friends that all like collectively were mean together. And yes, he does really awful things. There's a lot of bullying in this book, but it's part of the storyline. This book though did turn Game of Thrones very fast, and I am a huge fan of Game of Thrones, and so I think the twists and turns in this were amazing. The characters were amazing. I did not expect things to happen. The ending I was not seeing anywhere, and I was like jaw dropped, like what's happening? Halfway through this, my jaw was dropped and I was like, what is happening? There's so much action. Not as much romance as I would like. As you know, I am a huge romance fan, and so there's a little bit of romance that I didn't buy in the beginning. I just didn't believe it, and so like the way Jude reacted to something, I'm like, I don't know if that really warranted that reaction from you, but whatever. I did know the romance I was waiting for kind of gave a little bit, and I've heard it gets better in book two. But if you want romance in this, it's very, very minor subplot. I'm just a romance lover and I like cling to the romance in books. The main plot is of Jude figuring things out. I don't want to say anything. I think that the more blind you go into this, the more you'll enjoy it. I don't want to do this, but comparing it to A Court of Thorns and Roses, I did love that series more because of the romance, but I gave this book a 5 out of 5 stars. I love the world building. I love the characters. I love the fae aspects of the world. I love the cruel prince who is definitely not a likable person. And so I absolutely loved his character. I loved the turn things took. I loved all the twists and turns. It kept me on my toes. I definitely think this is worth the hype. I think you guys should check it out. If you were wondering if you should or not, I recommend you do. I already bought book two. I already can't wait to read it, though I'm very terrified of the cliffhanger of book two, because now I'm gonna have to wait a year for book three. I only have to wait like a week to read book two. So we'll see how I feel about reading book two. But I would love to know your thoughts. What did you think of The Cruel Prince if you read it? Leave your thoughts down below. There are people who are obsessed with it, and then there are people who are like, I don't get the hype. I get the hype. I'm not obsessed, but I really enjoyed it, and I think it is a great fantasy to read, and I'm really happy I picked it up, and I'm getting a copy of the first book definitely to add to my shelves. And my sister is currently in the middle of it. She is about halfway through, and it's due back to the library tomorrow. So she's gonna read half this book in a day. I read this book in 2 days. I gobbled through it. It was amazing. I loved it. So I definitely recommend to everybody. Final consensus, it was definitely worth the hype. And those are my thoughts on The Cruel Prince. Like I said, let me know down below what you thought and what your favorite parts of it were. I would love to know. As always, thank you so much for watching and have a good day. Bye.